Hi and welcome. In this video, I will discuss a software vulnerability which is known as time of check and time of use or race condition. So it is a software bug which is mostly found in Linux or database transactions. So what happens that system checks a condition, and after it has checked this condition, there are certain changes happen in the system. Then the result of previously checked condition are used. But since the system has now changed, so these results are used in an unauthorized way or in conflict with the recent changes in the system. So now I will discuss two scenarios of this race condition or time of check or time of use. The first one is the expired authorization, which is an unintentional time of check and time of use or race condition. And second one is the intentional or malicious time of check and time of use attack. That is, the malicious user is altering the condition after it is checked by the system. So coming over to the first scenario, a user requests to change a web page and system grants him this access and provide him with a web form to edit the page and then to submit his request. So this is the time of check by the system. Now afterward, the admin makes certain changes in the system and blocks this editing. But since the user was previously checked and was allowed to access the editing form, so he is doing editing at his own end. After the user has edited the web page, he submits his editing form, and this form is accepted by the system. That is the time of use. So here you can see that there is a conflict between the recent changes made by the admin and this acceptance of user input by the system. But it was a non-intentional conflict or time of check or time of use. And now I will discuss the intentional or malicious altering of or using of or taking advantage of time of check and time of use. In this case, the system checks the user's authorization for a normal file, which is not a system file. And after system has checked this authorization, the system gets engaged in other tasks because it is a multitasking system. Now, malicious user takes advantage of this time of check, and he changes this normal file with a link to password hashes on a Linux system. Then, after doing the other task, system opens this link thinking that it is the old normal file, and the malicious user gets access to the password hashes. So here you can see that certain changes happened in the system by the malicious user, and since at the time of check the system has already checked the user permissions, so the system got tricked by the malicious user in opening the sensitive system file. So this was all from my side. Please stay connected to my channel for similar videos. Thank you.